after the fifth carboplatin, and she's taking TA-65 this whole time, they repeated the X-ray, and it seemed to get smaller. Instead of a Brazil nut, it looks more like an earplug or something. And this looks a bit more diffuse rather than the usual course, which would be more defined and more opaque. So certainly not a progression, but something that giving Kathy a bit of hope as well. So clinically, Lulu's voice had been hoarse for a while. She'd been gagging and coughing, clearing her throat, but that went away fairly quickly after starting TA-65. Another clinical sign was that she had clumps of hair that were falling out for the initial weeks, which we see in humans too in some ways, not really clumps of hair, but new skin, new hair. And Kathy likened it to as if she were shedding and then putting on a new coat, entirely new coat of fur. Subjectively, Lulu seemed very happy and her appetite increased, and she seemed to sleep much deeper and snore less. Other holistic things that were done were acupuncture, right, continues, and she's eating a diet of organic chicken, broccoli, and sweet potatoes. Certainly doesn't hurt. So regarding the TA-65 dose, initially she gave 2 a day, and then I think that Lula's been on a steady 5 a day now, initially with yogurt prior to sleep, but now capsules embedded in cream cheese. Before we wind up, I just want to mention what osteosarcoma looks like in dogs usually. So 90% of the time, it's already spread to the lungs. Even if it's not visible on that initial X-ray, it's like little dandelion seeds. They're in there, spread by the blood, and it's just a matter of time before they flower into these multiple lucencies, which will eventually overwhelm the animal. The median survival, if you don't do amputation, is only 3 months, and radiation has really no role except for palliation, which is dubious. With chemotherapy, which has been recommended, the median survival can get up to a year, although usually the quality of life, I'm told, is not very good during that year, and there's constant recurrence. And then some, you might quote a 15% cure with chemo.
Nice to your friends. She's very nice.
So you got old dog over there too.
Oh great, how old's yours?
She'll be 14 next month.
Aw, she's 12 and a half.
Is she?
She just lost her leg 5 months ago, but she's doing really well.
Oh.
Yeah.
This is Lulu Reinheimer getting her 6th treatment of carboplatin.
Boinga. There we go. Go get it. Good girl. Good girl. What a girl. What a girl. Yes, honey. Yeah, girl. What a girl, honey. Ding, ding. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Hey, come on, honey. Yeah, it's my girl. Yeah, it's my girl. What a girl. Okay. Okay.
So, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. And I'm sitting here in my kitchen with Lulu. She's taking a little rest because we had a little walk this morning.
How do you feel like she's done since the... Well, tell us, you saw the clinical points. So during
yes.
that whole spring, early summer, have you noticed changes in Lulu? Or?
Yeah, well, her energy is so much better. You know, with the terrible infection she got after the surgery and so on, she was sort of a zombie, but she's an incredible trooper.
Mm.
But she is just so energetic. No one can believe she's 12 years and 7 months.
Hmm.
I mean, just no one. And, you know, she looks great. She smells everything. She sees everything. She's very quick reflexes, even on the 3 legs. And I'm just, you know, astonished, and I couldn't be happier. I'm just
really?
So happy about it.
So, like, say, this time last year, was it the same? Would she have been able to do all those things? And how was the general?
Well, you know what? When I look back, it was probably around September or October. She started to get a bit lethargic, and she wasn't limping, but I did notice her energy was low, and she was actually pretty heavy. Because we weren't taking as many hikes. She used to get really, really hot in summertime with her black fur and everything. But in retrospect, I sort of attribute that to maybe the beginning of that big tumor growing in her leg.
Yeah.
And just, low energy and so on. And, it's the same dog. Lulu's the same dog, but it's like Lulu 5 years ago,
really?
As opposed to Lulu last year. You know what I mean?
Right. So you feel as though she's a little perkier than she was in the recent years, or?
More than a little perky. She's very perky. She's very just love of life and incredible energy. She still comes into my room every morning and wakes me up. And, waits till I get out of bed to let her out. And she's just clockwork. She's just right there. It's amazing.
Now, I was looking at, seeing the pictures are very different, but the fur seemed a little bit more thick. And have you comment about her fur quality?
Actually, her vet mentioned that also. Mm. Just her fur, except for her little face, which, has a bunch of gray in it, and on her belly side. I'm looking at her right now. Her fur is just so jet black, and I'm feeling it right now, and it has that sort of lanolin feeling,
right.
Of when your hair is really nicely conditioned. And, I wish if people could just give TA-65 to their dogs just for fur, that would be fantastic. But no, I'm amazed at her fur, and that's why nobody can believe she's 12 and 7 months. There are no dry areas. There used to be, because we live in a very dry climate. She used to have a little bit of eczema or whatever that was, just flaky skin.
Yeah.
And I have seen none in months and months.
Yeah. So is the appetite?
Yeah, the
better?
Big molting has stopped, and now she just has a beautiful coat of fur.
Beautiful. And now, you said she was a little heavy last fall. Has she gained weight since then, or lost weight, or how's the eating?
No, she's lost weight. With this organic diet I've got her on, with the chicken and the broccoli and the sweet potatoes, it's called the Trinity Diet, and it's especially devised for dogs with cancer. She's really lost weight on that, but also I think because her energy is so much better, she burns maybe more calories or something.
Yeah.
She's pretty lean. I used to sort of behind her neck, on the back of her neck, I'd be able to hold that skin, there. And now I can't. I'm feeling it right now, and it just goes smoothly from the back of her neck down her back.
Right, and that we see that with people, too, who get accused of getting facelifts, because the connective tissue under the skin, the deep dermis, tightens up like a shrinky-dink, so the skin gets tighter, which is nice.
Right.
Yeah. So now let's talk about the big problem, which is the osteosarcoma. Now, when they told you in December that she had that, what was the tone? I mean, were they telling you that, it seems like the research I did said that most dogs suffer a lot and then probably die within half a year.
Yeah, what several vets said, and they are not vets I go to anymore, said, you're essentially, as the owner, buying time. because it's hard to say goodbye. That was the line said to me over and over and over. And, you know, even though that was a hard thing to even face, I thought, well, I'm going to do it anyway. But I never realized she'd have this kind of quality of life, even through the chemo. And every time I go into the vet we go to now, who does acupuncture for her and who is all for the TA-65, in fact, there's another dog here who has now gone on TA-65, and our vet condones it. Everybody at that vet office are always astounded when they see Lulu. They just, you know, can't believe how happy, healthy, her breathing is fine, even with this little nodule that, you know, we've seen on the scans.
Yeah.
There doesn't seem to be any change in her her energy or her breathing or her ability to run around and so on. So I'm thrilled about that.
That's great. And, you know, we have to emphasize that TA-65 is not a cure for cancer.
Right.
And it's just something that can help your immune system be stronger because of the, and it's, that's been shown. So we don't know really what Lulu's lungs were like January through April because no x-ray was done. There may have been nothing. There may have been several that have now gone down to one. You just don't
right.
know. It's a moving target. But certainly not being a radiologist, the June looked a little better than the May, smaller and lighter. So
yes.
that's great. So we have another one of those coming up, right, in a few weeks?
Oh, yeah. In August, second week of August, or, yeah, end of the first week, we will do another x-ray. I think they just don't want to give her too many x-rays unless it's absolutely necessary. So she seems to be doing fine, so...
Good. Well, let's talk about something, because I know one of our regulars hung up. I think he was a little bit disgusted. I don't know why. But obviously, you feel like Lulu is, you know, important to you, and like you call her your daughter, basically. And so
yeah.
I think some people who are not pet lovers might say, well, why would you go so far? Why not just put her out to the farm? And can you explain, like, you know, where you're coming from in terms of that? Decision,
I will. Lulu's dad, a beautiful black lab, was my favorite dog about 12 years ago or, you know, 15 years ago. And I actually arranged the mating between that dog and a female lab
mm-hmm.
so that I could have an offspring of this male sire.
Wow.
And so you could say I sort of, you know, arrange the surrogate.
Yeah, it's like it sounds like people with infertility getting donor eggs.
Right.
Yeah. Wow.
And you know what? I don't have children, and I teach children, but Lulu is like a daughter to me. I mean, and I think the strength of the webinars that I saw on the TA-65. While also knowing that it had really helped several of the cancer patients that I know,
mm-hmm.
I thought, why not? Why not give her something that won't hurt her? I'd rather put my money there than somewhere else. And I feel like these last 7 months have been among the best months of her life.
Really?
And I didn't feel like she was ready to go. And I don't believe that even in the face of not having an absolute cure for cancer, there isn't so much we can do to slow down the process and so on. And this is one of those incredible supplements.